Let me tell you what resiliency is not. It's not a mood, right? It's not just, oh God, if only we were, you know, just did more yoga and, you know, made more love, like everything would be fine, right? Like, it's not a mood, right? It is actually investments in a system that is going to be more resilient to the boom. In other words, if you assume the boom, you're going to actually realize that there are things that you have failed to do to protect the system. This idea of resiliency actually has sort of a pop corollary besides Taylor Swift in this notion of keep calm and carry on, right? We hear it all the time, you know, look, we're just, you know, bad things will happen, and if we just sort of hunker down and come back, we're going to be fine. The keep calm and carry on mantra, I have to say, as many of you who are from Boston know, has its variants, whether it's keep calm and be fabulous, keep calm and don't let idiots ruin your day, that's a good one, or keep calm and eat chocolate, right? These are the variants. Like, if we just sort of just chill out, right, we're going to be fine. And this idea of keeping calm and carry on, I think, is very misleading and is so, and is doubly misleading because it's not even true. This idea, most of you have heard of keep calm and carry on. So keep calm and carry on sort of hits our sort of zeitgeist as Americans in about, ironically, 2005 when Hurricane Katrina hits. And where did it come from? So most people who know this keep calm and carry on, most people think it comes from World War II, right? This, now, talk about an existential threat, right? Hitler is now in France. British are about to be bombarded by aerial war strikes. Churchill is hunkered down in his war councils underneath London. And so he starts to commission, at least he starts to commission statements, sort of public statements to the world, to Brits, to get them engaged with the war. These include the ones, the very famous one, loose lips sink ships, right? This idea that you have to be quiet. And so keep calm and carry on, when we start talking about it, is assumed to have been part of this Churchill mandate until someone actually figures it out. So this man owns a old bookstore in northern England. And in about 2005, he's looking in some old boxes in the back, and he opens one up, and there's all these posters. And he thinks they're really charming and witty. He puts them out. And people come by and they go, that's really interesting. What's the history of that? He goes, I actually don't know. People start buying it. A magazine does a story on it. And that's when you sort of see the wildfire of this sort of idea of, like, resiliency is just a mood. It's just sort of hunkering down. Turns out it was all a lie. Churchill did commission the statement. 2 million posters were made. They were going to go throughout London until he killed it. I mean, in other words, he didn't want it circulated. And why not? Because it was too passive, right? When you're actually threatened with the boom, right? And as I said, talk about an existential threat. That's not what he needed Londoners to do. You're not going to keep calm. The men are going to go to war. The women are going to go to work. And they are going to send their children to the countryside. In other words, if you think about resiliency and what it means as a word, re means back. We all know that. But in Latin, resiliency means jumping. Think about it as an active thing. Right, it's not just sort of your, you know, it is actually moving forward in meaningful ways.